Karl Malone, known as the Mailman, is one of the greatest power forwards to ever play, but he does have a bit of a reputation of choking, like when he missed two free throws with Game 1 of the 1997 Finals on the line, which then led to Michael Jordan's game-winning basket at the buzzer. Scottie Pippen then said the famous line, "The Mailman doesn't deliver on Sundays." A few other instances of Karl Malone's worst moments would be the 1991 NBA All-Star Game, when he committed the biggest All-Star Game blunder in league history, when for some reason, he blocked his own teammate's game-winning basket, which resulted in the Western Conference losing the game. Also, Game 6 of the 1998 NBA Finals, when his Jazz are up by 1 point in the closing moments, but Karl turns the ball over, which leads to Michael Jordan's championship-winning shot. Also on November 3rd, 2002, against the Seattle Supersonics, when he had the worst game of his career according to the game score stat. His game score was a negative 7.8, and he had 0 points and 4 turnovers on a terrible 0 of 7 shooting. The craziest part is that I don't think anyone realizes how prophetic this statement was from Scottie Pippen, because all 4 of these worst moments of Karl Malone's career each took place on a Sunday. Many basketball fans argue about who's the GOAT player, who's the GOAT coach, and even things like who's the GOAT general manager. But we rarely talk about who's the GOAT NBA employee overall. When all factors are considered, that might just be Larry Bird, as Larry Legend is the only person in NBA history to win league MVP, coach of the year, and executive of the year all in his career. Only 2 players in league history have averaged over 30 points and over 10 assists in a single NBA Finals series. Any guesses on who those 2 players are? They're 2 players who continue to find themselves on their own list, Michael Jordan and LeBron James. The Warriors are currently sitting in the 9th spot in the Western Conference, and despite the fact that they might miss the playoffs, a few people still see Steph Curry as an MVP candidate. Well, assuming they miss the playoffs, and if somehow Steph miraculously won the award, it actually wouldn't be the first time a player has been named the MVP while missing the playoffs. That was Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in the 75-76 season with only a 40-42 record. Legendary Boston Celtics head coach Red Auerbach was known for his brilliant mind and his ability to lead teams to win championships, but he was also a man who was fiercely competitive and had quite the temper with referees. Nothing better illustrates that than the fact that he is the only person who has ever been ejected from an NBA All-Star game. It was the 1967 All-Star Game, where his Eastern Conference lost to the Western Conference 135-120. From the NBA's birth until the year 1973, every All-Star Game had to be represented with at least one player from every team in the league. In theory, this inclusive rule sounds like a pretty good idea. Well, that was until the 1973 All-Star Game, because the Philadelphia 76ers were represented by their 6'9 power forward, John Block. Not only was John nowhere close to superstar material, but his 76ers finished that season with a 9-73 record. Now it's starting to make sense why the NBA got rid of that representation rule the following season. We all know the modern NBA has been shooting more three-pointers than in years past, but few stats sum that up better than this one. 30 years ago, the Run TMC Warriors were providing some offensive excitement to the Western Conference. The team's 3 stars were Chris Mullin, Tim Hardaway, and Mitch Richmond, who were all considered as elite three-point shooters, and that entire Warriors team attempted 9.8 three-point attempts per game. This season, Steph Curry by himself is shooting 12.3 three-point attempts per game. This player won the league MVP, but he did it with the fewest games played in a full-length season of any MVP in league history. He participated in only 58 of his team's 82 games that season. Any guesses on who that player is? It was the consistently injured, but incredibly talented, Bill Walton in 1978. The triple-double is an impressive feat, but for some players specifically, it's just another day at the office. But what's even more impressive is a player achieving a triple-double with 0 turnovers. Since the 1990s, less than 20 players have accomplished that feat, and the player who's done it more times is none other than Jason Kidd, who had 5 of these flawless triple-double games. In his career, Russell Westbrook has a total of 179 triple-doubles, but quite surprisingly, in only one of those games did he have 0 turnovers, which really tells you how rare that accomplishment is. That game was against the Blazers in 2016. Most scoring records we've heard so many times that most of us could list them off without hardly thinking about it. The most points scored in a game was Wilt Chamberlain with 100, second place is Kobe Bryant with 81, and the most points ever scored in an NBA playoff game was Michael Jordan with 63. But in each of those games, those guys shot a ton of free throws. The most points ever scored by a player who didn't attempt a single free throw was Hakeem Olajuwon in 1997 against the Denver Nuggets, where he scored 48 points on 24 of 40 from the field. The NBA has really grown since the 60s, and no stat may better prove that point than this one. Wilt Chamberlain played in the NBA from the late 50s until the early 70s, and in the totality of his career, he made $2.5 million over that stretch. On the other hand, there's Steph Curry, who plays for the Warriors just like Wilt did. But every six games, Steph makes more money than Wilt Chamberlain did over his entire career. The Toronto Raptors have become a stable and successful franchise within the National Basketball Association, but they actually were not the first NBA team in Canada. And no, I'm not talking about the Vancouver Grizzlies either. The first ever Canada team was actually the 1946-47 Toronto Huskies. Unfortunately, the Huskies finished with only a 22-38 record, and combine that with Canada not receiving basketball with open arms at the time, and the team was only around for just one season. It was the 2010 season, and Corey Maggette was a member of the Milwaukee Bucks, and his Bucks were taking on the Minnesota Timberwolves. Maggette was only a role player at this point, but he was still known to be aggressive, and on this night, he channeled his inner James Harden, and in only 10 minutes of play, he shot 20 free throws and made 17 of them. Wilt Chamberlain was incredible, we all know this. But among his incredible stats and accomplishments, Wilt also said that he had a 52-inch vertical leap, that he bench-pressed nearly 600 pounds, he travels across the country driving as fast as 180 miles per hour, he started his famous 20,000 stat when he was only 5 years old, and a mountain lion once attacked him, and he grabbed it by the tail and threw it into the bushes. Now, is it a fact that Wilt Chamberlain actually did these things? Well, we don't know for sure, but it is a fact that Wilt Chamberlain said that he did. Which one of these facts was the most interesting, and do you have any new facts to share with the rest of us? Let me know in the comments section below. Thanks for watching as always. Make sure to like and subscribe for more basketball content, and I'll see you guys in the next video.